My name is Oluwaseyi Omojalabi. Can we meet you, sir?
My name is Shoma Bagoredi, the Honorable Commissioner for Youth and Sports in the United States.
Okay, thank you, sir. So, there is a saying that politics is a dirty game, which makes most Christians not want to go into it because they feel there's no way they want to go into it and end up in the dirty games. So, my first question is, what has been your greatest challenge being a Christian and excelling as a bright star in politics?
The first thing is, you know, politics is not a game, you know, and it shouldn't be treated, you know, as a game. So, which, you know, automatically, you know, discredits and confound that, you know, saying that it is a dirty, you know, game. So now, yeah, we understand that, you know, there are a lot of people that could actually, you know, exercise, you know, politics the way it's meant to be, like that. And that's the more reason why we need, you know, people with clean hands, you know, people that, you know, they have, you know, good reputation, antecedents, you know, to step up, you know, to want to come and, you know, and take positions, you know, in government. Because if we keep saying that, oh yeah, I'm good, I don't want, and keep running away, the ones that are bad would definitely occupy, you know, the spaces that we have, the positions that we have. And what could actually be the result of a bad person? You know, the byproduct, you know, a bad, you know, person is still going to be bad. So, and that is why we shouldn't expect anything better if, you know, we continue to live like this, and then the good ones, you know, continue to run away from. So if politics is not, you know, so good, let us go into it, especially as believers. Let us go into it. Because, you know, one thing that, you know, you should actually, you know, consider is when, you know, the world, when God was going to give us the Great Commission mandate, what did he say? He said, go ye into the world, preach the gospel to those that what? That are unsaved. He didn't say, let us therefore create, you know, a new world where, you know, all of us, you know, will be, you know, pure, where all of us, you know, will be sacrosanct and righteous. No, he said, but go into that dirty world. Preach the gospel, you know, to people, to those dirty people, and then, you know, let them, you know, accept, you know, Christ, you know, as their personal Lord and Savior. So that is the same way it is now. So if, even if, you know, we are going to assume that it is, you know, indeed, you know, dirty, that is why we need us, you know, to go into that debt to clean it up. Huh? So, I mean, it's just like, you know, you say you are dirty and then you are running away from the bathroom. How then will you be clean? So, you know, when you are dirty, is the more reason why you should go into the bathroom to take a shower. So if it is dirty, is the more reason why we have, you know, the cleaning agent or the cleansing agent to go in there. Because they will not come to us to get cleaned. You know, we go to them. Do you get? So, and, you know, that's just the way it is. It's the people that go to school. The school doesn't come to the people. So in this context, you know, we are the one that will go to them. Because we are the one that will go and, you know, cleanse that place up. Because we know that, of course, the fact that they are dirty, we don't want to make them associate with us. So it is we that will go with our knowledge, with our wisdom, with the capacity that we have, you know, to go and, you know, change, you know, things, you know, from inside, you know, out. So that's why we need to enter in their midst. Jesus Christ too, you know, when he was going to come and do, you know, a lot of things that he didn't stand, you know, in heaven. You know, he didn't stay in heaven to influence the world. He had to come to be part of the world. So if we are going to change anything, we have to go to be part of that, you know, system. But of course, you know, he was in the world. He was not corrupted by the world. So it is possible for you to go into the world of politics and not, you know, get corrupted, you know, by the things that happen, you know, in there. So, you know, no matter how we put it, you know, there will never be any justifiable, you know, reason for anybody whatsoever, be it you're a believer or anybody, not to be part of the polity that actually determines, you know, the way you live your life. Because if we are not careful, you know, they will just come, you know, together one day, and then they will institute, you know, policy that will make it unbearable to live if you are not, you know, part of, you know, the fold that they belong to. So that is why we need to work and learn to do things, you know, better.
Thank you very much, Samuel. So now, what is your advice for youth that aspires to go into politics, and how can they shine as bright stars in politics?
Okay, so my advice is just, you know, for them to step out, to go for it. You know, that's all. It's not rocket science. Whatever, you know, you need to be part of, you know, go for it. If there are youth parliaments, you know, around, you know, wherever you are, go and join the youth parliament. If, you know, there are political, you know, parties wherever, or political meetings wherever you are, you know, be part of the political meetings. Do you get? If they are saying that, oh, we have a town hall meeting where we're going to talk about how the affairs of this town will be directed, go and be part of it. When you need to talk, raise up your hand to talk. Let people know that. And then, you know, by so doing, you are visible to people. So when, if there are opportunities, you know, like this, like the one that I'm serving at the moment, which, you know, I mean, I didn't bid for it. I didn't, you know, go lobby for it. It's just because of the fact that, you know, they know that, you know, yeah, you know, this person, you know, he has the potential and he has been doing a lot of things, you know, in this regard. So let us call upon him to come and serve, you know, his own home. And I consider it as an opportunity to be of service, you know, to my own local, you know, community. Yeah? So that is the, you know, the thing that we need to do. And I believe that, you know, everything starts, you know, by consciousness. And be involved, be deliberate about, you know, your involvement. And before we know it, the nation, you know, our community will change for the better.
Thank you very much,
You're
sir.
Welcome.
Thank you for your time, yeah. Sir.